Traditional Indigenous drama has always featured strongly and consistently in their culture. Traditional Indigenous performance works alternately between speech and silence, between the past and the present, and between performance and story. This may include dancing, acting, music, body paint, ritual, and song. The purpose of Australian Indigenous drama often is to share knowledge that related to local stories, geography, or animals. Storytelling has always been a part of Indigenous heritage, not just as entertainment, but as an essential part of passing down the lore and lineage of each group. One type of traditional Indigenous theatre or drama is dreamtime drama. It can be either storytelling, like we see here in this video, told, spoken, or it could be by song and then danced or acted out. Often corroborees involve a combination of song drama and dreamtime drama. The songs and dances performed, unlike initiation ceremonies, are normally not secret and pass on information about the dreaming.
And here to tell another version of what he thinks the dreamtime story is my good friend and mentor, Tookaby.
Hello, boys and girls. How are you today? That's good. We were all moulded in one part of the dreaming, or what we call the Jogarpa. We were all moulded from the earth. And we all gave wongan. Wongan. We all got speech, or lila. We were given a song. And with that song came the medicine. And the medicine, the story for the country. And we believe that we come from the country, because we were moulded, given birth from her. And when we finish up, or when we pass on, we go back to her. We become a part of her. So that's another way of saying, talking about the dreaming. And the songs are very important. It's like a jigsaw puzzle. And when you sing all the songs, you're putting all the little jigsaw puzzle together. And it becomes a big map. And the map is Australia.
Inside of the songs, you have information. And inside of the songs, you might be told to stop here and make a camp. You might be told inside the songs that this is where you find food, this is where you find water, and this is where you find shelter. So if you know your language, then you know your song. If you know your song, you'll never get lost. You'll always find shelter, you'll always have food and water. So that is another small aspect of what the dreamtime is. So now let's make sense of it all. This is a song from my grandma's people, and it's talking about Garia, or Garia, the rainbow serpent. And when I say the word Gunmali, it means to make. And I say Gunmali Gabanyamba, we're going to make the sweet mother. Because that's what most people's idea of the dream time is, how things started. Look at any different religion, it always talks about how things came to be. Okay, so we're going to tell a story about the rainbow serpent creating everything. And here's my good friend Norm on what we call Yidaki, commonly known as the didgeridoo. Now, this is Tookaby's version of a different creation song from a different part of Australia.
The next drama we're going to look at is Indigenous totem drama. It is done as a sung story, but unlike creation or dreaming stories, it doesn't necessarily have to revolve around the creation. It involves the use of specific movements, a specific setting or built set for the drama. In totem drama, the group tells the story and takes on the qualities of the creature or plant that is the subject matter for the drama. The actions are usually involving mime and exaggerated movement, and they often act out the part of the story that's being sung. They enact the encounters of the first Australians with giant mammals, such as the giant emu. Often totem dramas involve the use of a totem or an animal as the central focus point to dance dramas and rituals. Symbols are often painted on the face and the body of participants. This is an example of a totem drama that we are seeing here. These totem dramas can tell stories of animals or stories of their history. For example, there's very specific evidence that the totem dramas actually have recorded a volcanic eruption that was in New Zealand many thousands of years ago. And they were able to trace that this volcanic explosion happened using the data that they found at the volcanic site. However, the Indigenous people of Australia saw that the black clouds in the sky and made a totem drama about it. There's one way that we know that Aboriginal people are very specific and detail-focused with their storytelling, and that it's very accurate because they've described events that had no scientific proof to back them up until much later on. And we can go back to those stories and say, well, they recorded it accurately. The first published plays written by Aboriginal people were in the 1970s. The first official black theatre was built in 1973, where Basically Black, the video that we're watching, was performed and created. The first Aboriginal plays that were published were mainly concerned with issues of contemporary survival and colonisation. For example, Merritt, Gilbert and Bostock, all very prominent Indigenous playwrights, present moments of the daily reality and humanity of modern Aboriginal life drawn from their own experience. The Black Power movement in America inspired a lot of early Indigenous theatre. Bob Mazza, one of the actors we see here, travelled to a conference in America and saw black theatre. He, along with Jack Charles, who is still alive today and still acts in local Perth productions, started getting black theatre really going. There was street theatre as well, against mining companies mining Aboriginal land. The Aboriginal Tent Embassy included street theatre and protesting. It was peaceful. Bob Mazza's vision was to bring theatre down to the people as it belongs to them. Quote from Mazza. What we see here is a theatre show called Basically Black that turned into a TV series for a limited run in the 1970s. It was written by Bob Mazza.
So stand back for the brown new black. And Mr. Gubb, I'm basically black.
Here's some footage from Basically Black, the TV show.
Thought we might have a man-to-man chat, Elidge.
What for?
Well, I thought, or rather Christine's mother felt, that is, we both felt, it seems you've been seeing a daughter lately.
Well, of course I have. I live with her, don't I?
Yes. Frankly, that's rather what I wanted to talk to you about. Christine's mother's a little worried, you know. And we... were wondering when you and Christine were thinking of getting married.
Marriage? That's just what you'd say, isn't it? Chris and me don't need any white, reactionary, middle-class ideas like marriage. I spit on marriage. We've got a revolutionary relationship, pal. And we're going to go on living together until I take it to Mozambique and we join the black guerrilla forces there and we both fight until we die. And if you don't like it, then that's too bloody bad.
There you are, my dear. Nothing to worry about. He's not going to marry Christine after all.
White fella don't like black fella, Taka. White fella say black fella taka only fit for black fella. White fella say nice fat guana burnt on campfire so all the guts shrivel up into little ball. White fella say that no good. White fella don't want nothing to do with that sort of taka. White fella damn smart sometime.
You know what? In the long run, I reckon we'd be better off with a more restrictive immigration policy.
A prominent WA playwright is Jack Davies. He's internationally renowned and wrote plays not just to inform people and talk about political issues, but also to entertain. By the 90s, Aboriginal stories became more commonplace in mainstream media. This is a segment on the 90s comedy sitcom Fast Forward.
I've got $290,000 for this magnificent property. It's got parking for two Volvos. $320,000 against you, sir. $320,000 for this magnificent opportunity. $320,000 once. $320,000 twice.
Good pride, brother. When you're moving in.
$320,000 $20,000 for this magnificent property. Will somebody give me one more bid, please?
Oh, nice house, all right. We like good neighbors. We quiet mob, us mob. You ask local police.
$320,000.
Well, no trouble around here. No drinking, no fighting.
I'm just going to toss it back open at 300. Let's call it 300.
Yeah.
290.
And that's no good, because we've got to get up 5 o'clock in the morning for a crobbery. But the crowd's not coming down. And next weekend, Alice Springs mob, desert break. Oh, they've got no class, I'm gonna.
Ladies and gentlemen, will somebody give me, say, $150,000, $140,000. I'm not being greedy, ladies and gentlemen. $100,000. Come on, ladies and gentlemen.
You can come up and watch a video with us. We're going to learn the road. Bloody good boxer, don't bother.
Somebody give me $100,000, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, you want to buy it? You buy it, we have a barbecue. I'll get a kangaroo. Mrs. in here, when I cook a dapper for you. Or when get a bear money. Big fish, that bear money. Hey, you like your crocodile legs? You like a boat or you like a bride?
50, 40, 30. I'm not fussing, ladies and gentlemen. Will somebody start me off, ladies and gentlemen? Pete!
What do you reckon, brother?
Prepare to take any offer at this time, ladies and gentlemen. Anything at all, please.
I'll swap you for the HR over there, right?
I have barely been one HR holding for the property. The HR once, twice, three times done.
Thank you, brother. Now, the next auction's in half an hour.
I don't think we paid you.
This led to more Indigenous plays being produced, including musicals such as Brand New Day.
There's nothing I would rather be than to be an Aborigine and watch you take my precious lad away. For nothing gives me greater joy than to watch you feel each girl and boy with superficial existential. You might think I'm cheeky, but I'd be satisfied to rebuild your convict ships and sail you on the tide. There's nothing I would rather be than to be an Aborigine and dream of just what heaven must be like. Where must and rust do not corrupt, when I die I know I'm growing up, cause you know that I've had my hell on earth. God gave us 10 commandments, we know we are informed. Judgment day is coming. We're always being warned.
Now, of course, that's not an entire complete history of all Aboriginal theatre that's ever been written. That would take us quite a few hours. But I hope you can see kind of how the timeline went and can appreciate that all of these Australian playwrights and TV show producers and film producers helped bring Aboriginal stories into the mainstream. And you can see how it's kind of progressed over time to be educational, political, traditional, ritual, and everything else that it could possibly be. Thanks so much, guys. I'll see you next time.